Welcome to all of you. Today's our discussion topic is pulse width modulation inverters. Okay, nowadays in many of the industrial applications, the PWM inverters are widely used. The PWM techniques are characterized by the constant amplitude pulses. The width of these pulses is modulated to obtain inverter output voltage control and to reduce its harmonic content present in the output voltage. Different PWM techniques are listed below. First one is the single pulse modulation, second one is the multiple pulse modulation, and third one is nothing but the sinusoidal pulse modulation. In PWM inverter, the forced commutation is essential. The three methods listed above differ from each other in the harmonic content present in their respective output voltages. The choice of a particular PWM technique depends upon the permissible harmonic content present in the output voltage. So firstly, we are going to see the single pulse modulation PWM technique. Okay, so we will start our discussion with single pulse modulation technique. Okay, so here the figure shows output voltage waveform from a single phase full bridge inverter. Okay, here the maximum output voltage of single phase bridge inverter is plus minus Vs. Okay, when this waveform is modulated, the output voltage waveform is as shown in the figure provided here. Okay, it consists of a pulse of width 2D located symmetrically about pi by 2, and another pulse is located symmetrically about 3 pi by 2. The range of the pulse width 2D varies from 0 to pi. Okay, that means the range of this pulse width is it is in between 0 to pi. Okay, the maximum and minimum limits are provided for this 2D. It ranges from 0 to pi here. Okay, the output voltage is controlled by varying this pulse width 2D. Okay, the shape of the output voltage is known as the Cauchy square wave. Okay, we will continue our discussion with the Fourier series analysis of the output waveform. Okay, the Fourier series analysis gives here, the coefficient An is equivalent to 2 by pi integral from pi by 2 minus d to pi by 2 plus d, Vs sin n omega t d omega t. Okay, so now why the limits are pi by 2 minus d and pi by 2 plus d? See here, our pulse width is 2d. So this total duration is nothing but d. Okay, so that this duration, your pulse starts here from pi by 2 minus d, is pi by 2 minus d, and here pulse ends at pi by 2 plus d. It is pi by 2 plus d. So the limits we have taken as pi by 2 minus d to pi by 2 plus d. Vs is the maximum amplitude, sin n omega t d omega t here. Okay, so after solving this, we are obtaining An is equivalent to Vs divided by n pi into sin n pi by 2 into sin n d. So how it will be? We have to solve this equation for the provided limits. Okay, so here it is. An is equivalent to 2 by pi integral from pi by 2 minus d to pi by 2 plus d Vs sin n omega t d omega t. Okay, Vs is constant, take it outside, 2 Vs divided by pi. Okay, the integral of sin n omega t is cos n omega t divided by n. The lower and upper limits are pi by 2 minus d, pi by 2 plus d. Okay, substituting this all upper and lower limits, we have An is equivalent to 2 Vs divided by pi into cos n pi by 2 plus d minus cos n pi by 2 minus d whole divided by n. So it will be 2 Vs divided by n pi into 2 times sine n pi by 2 into sine n d. So this is nothing but 4 Vs divided by n pi to sine n pi by 2 into sine n d. Okay, so that's why an is equivalent to this term. Okay, this is our equation number 1. Okay, so here we can observe that the positive and negative half cycles of V out are symmetrical about pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2 respectively. Okay, so that the component Bn is equivalent to 0 here. Okay, thus the output voltage waveform can be described by the Fourier series analysis as V out is equivalent to summation from n is equivalent to 1, 3, 5 up to infinity a n into sine n omega t. Okay, so here output voltage is equivalent to summation from n is equal to 1, 3, 5 to infinity. Replace the value of a n here. So 4 Vs divided by n pi sine n pi by 2 into sine n d into sine n omega t. Okay, so here V out will become equivalent to 4 Vs divided by pi into sine d sine omega t minus 1 by 3 sine 3 d into sine 3 omega t plus 1 by 5 into sine 5d into sine 5 omega t minus and so on. Okay, when the pulse width 2d is equivalent to pi radians, then the fundamental component of output voltage has peak value is equivalent to VO1m is equal to 4 Vs divided by pi. Okay, we will consider this as our equation number 1. For pulse width other than 2d is equivalent to pi radians, the peak value of fundamental component is given as 4 Vs divided by pi sine d. Okay, if nd is made equivalent to nd is equivalent to pi radians, or you can say d is equivalent to pi by n, or we can say 2d is equivalent to 2 pi by n. Okay, then the nth harmonic is eliminated from the inverter output. The peak value of nth harmonic is then given as VONM is equivalent to 4 Vs divided by n pi sine nd. Okay, so here if you take, this is our equation number 2, if we take the ratio of VONM divided by VO1M, then it will be VONM divided by VO1M is equivalent to sine nd sine nd divided by n. Where VO1m is nothing but the peak value of fundamental component of rectangular voltage waveform of width 2d is equivalent to pi radians. Okay, if you plot this ratio, then If we plot this ratio of VONM divided by VO1M, which is equivalent to sine ND divided by pi here, the graph will be like this for various pulse widths in degrees. This shows the harmonic content present in a single pulse width pulse width modulation technique. So here it is seen, here this graph shows the sine, this graph is nothing but for n is equivalent to 1, that is sine d. If we replace here n is equivalent to 1, it will be sine nd divided by n. So it is sine d. If you replace n is equivalent to 3 here, it will be sine 3d divided by 3. Here for n is equivalent to 5, it will be sine 5d divided by 5, and this is for sine 7d divided by 7, and so on. So it is seen from these above curves that when fundamental component is reduced to 0.5 for 2d is equivalent to 60 degree, then the amplitude of third harmonic is 1 by 3 sine 90 degree. So it will be equivalent to 0.33. So in the same way, if the fundamental component is reduced to 0.143, all the three harmonics, that is third, fifth and seventh harmonic component, becomes almost comparable with the fundamental component. This shows that in this method, the voltage control, in this method of voltage control, great deal of harmonic component is introduced in the output voltage, particularly at the low output voltage levels. The RMS value of the output voltage is given as VOR. R stands for the RMS value. Output voltage RMS value is given as Vs square into 2d divided by pi raised to 1/2, which can be given as Vs multiplied by 2d divided by pi raised to 1/2. This is nothing but the harmonic component, RMS value of the output voltage. So here we conclude that in single pulse modulation technique, it is the method of voltage control, but it will provide a great deal of harmonic content which is introduced in the output voltage, particularly at low output voltage levels. So this is our first method of pulse width modulation, that is single pulse modulation technique. Thank you all.